ඒක ඔන්ලයින් ගහනෝනම් අපිට මේක සර්වහකට යන්න නවා. ඒහින්
Death is coming.
Cut me down, please.
The gods are watching.
During the year of the Cobra, a prisoner captured by unknown means was transported into the exiled lands, crucified, and left to die for crimes that they may or may not have committed. Death comes swiftly on black wings, until fate intervenes.
Thirsty, dead man. Shall I cut you down from that corpse tree? It might kill you. You civilized men are soft. Your lives are not nailed to your spines. Where I come from, we kill our enemies in battle. We don't leave them in the desert to die like dogs. So, you live again, dead man. This land does not love men. You are marked, and you cannot cross the ghost fence wearing that. It might have been kinder to leave you on the cross. Live. Love. Burn with life. Slay and survive. We will meet again, dead man.
Curse this sandstorm. We were forced to take refuge before the wind scoured the skin from our faces. There is something in the storm. Beasts. We hear the skittering of their paws outside the ruins, and their howls mingle with the screaming winds. The men are scared. I've put them to work crafting rudimentary weapons and torches from the loose stones and rough plants that dot this place. I've yet to meet a beast that liked fire, or the bite of the axe.
Thank you. my father died, I knew they would be coming for me. It was only a matter of time. What I didn't expect was this. To be crucified and left to rot on the edge of a wasteland that I have never seen before. It makes sense to me that the cowardly fools that they sent to do the job would not have the courage to kill me. They are mongrels, the cast-off bloodlines of slaves and commoners, and such as they do not dare to spill royal blood. Instead, I was bound hand, foot, and mouth, and smuggled out to God's nowhere. They left me for the vultures, but I was rescued by a man. Such a man. Clean-limbed and bronze-skinned. I have never seen his like in the cities of Shem. He came to me as I hung from the cross, and his icy blue stare was a challenge. Did I dare to live? Now I crouch at the edge of this wasteland, once a daughter of princes, now a nameless exile in an unfamiliar land. The shaft of the double-bladed axe that he gave me is a comforting weight in my hands. The answer is yes. I will live.
Thank you.